It's Bea, and you're listening to another episode of the In Your Feelings podcast. I love reading your comments and your messages and your DMs and being in communication with all of you and hearing about how the words are helping. I have been receiving so many messages about my books, A Gentle Reminder and The Strength in Our Scars, and so many beautiful words relative to how they've been helping you heal and how they've been helping you find just like more love within yourself. And I thought it was lovely to almost bring it up at the end of this episode because I wrote those books, both of those books, when I was dealing with some of the most difficult moments of my life, when I was going through grief and an extreme heartbreak. And to know that I could show up and write those for you and that they're actually helping you through those seasons of your life, helping you to navigate your feelings, to learn that they are valid and to find strength within yourself to heal. It means the world to me. And so I just want to say thank you so much for all of your support. If you wanted to check those books out, they are available through the links below. But for the most part, I did just want to say I appreciate you so much. And thank you for being here. It means the absolute world to me. And just before we get into this episode, I did want to say thank you to Thought Catalog and to shopcatalog.com for helping to make all of this possible and for helping me to bring these podcast episodes to life for all of you. Today's episode is going to be reminders for a healing heart or just gentle words and encouragement that I think anyone who is currently navigating heartbreak could use. I am constantly in my DMs. I'm constantly reading your messages. So many of you beautiful human beings are reaching out to me right now, talking about what you're dealing with and how you're finding it difficult to move forward or to let go of someone who maybe has already let go of you, or to let go of a relationship that, you know, had potential but never came to fruition. And there are so many ways in which this world and the people that we connect with can weather our hearts. And there are so many things that we have to take into our healing. We have to take into account the fact that it's not linear. We have to remind ourselves that we can do hard things. And all the while, we have to be okay. We have to move forward. We have to pick up the pieces. And we have to move in the direction of healing. And that's really hard. And that is very messy and very difficult. And I feel like we put such a timeline on ourselves and on the process of healing. We tell ourselves that we're not healing fast enough. We tell ourselves that we shouldn't be so affected by something that was maybe a shorter connection. There are so many scenarios when it comes to healing, and I just wanted to give you a resource. I've talked about this on my podcast before. If you've listened to previous episodes on moving on and letting go and almost relationships, then some of the reminders in here might seem a little repetitive, or you might have heard me talk about them before. But the reason why I do this is because when I was healing, when I was navigating the loss of someone I genuinely thought was going to hold my heart forever, I had so many people and so many resources. I read so many books. I watched so many YouTube videos. My friends and I were in constant conversation and communication, and they were really holding me in my broken pieces. And I had to hear so many things recited back to me in so many different ways within the same realm of meaning, the same thing kind of just packaged by my friend, and then I would hear it in a YouTube video, and then I would read it in a book, and then I would read it in a book, and then I would write it myself. I had to hear those reminders consistently, and that is actually when they stuck. So I'm going to be your friend today. I am going to give you some words of encouragement, and whether you've heard them before or whether it's your first time hearing them, I hope they resonate with you. Healing is not easy. It is not easy to pick up your broken pieces and to dig through the dirt of everything that you're feeling and to even understand it. For that matter, we can put so much pressure on ourselves to release the memory of those who affected us deeply. And I want this episode to act as a reminder that you need to be gentle with yourself. You need to be gentle with your heart, and you need to understand that healing is not linear and that you are working through this in the best possible way that you can. All you need is a little bit of comfort, and I think probably someone to tell you that it's gonna be okay. So I volunteer as tribute. I have written out quite a few reminders that I know helped me when I was moving on. A few reminders that I needed someone to tell me. Things that I wish I had heard from those in my life, or I wish I had connected with so much sooner because they just clicked and made sense and helped to almost like soothe my heart. I can't heal your heart for you. I can't fix everything that went wrong. I can't give you closure, but I can give you comfort, and I can show up in the lessons that I learned, and I can show up in the things that I know I needed to hear. And so that's what this podcast is going to be for you. Come back to it whenever you need it, whenever you need someone to kind of hug your broken pieces back together, whenever you need to be reminded that you can do this, that you can do hard things, that you have the capacity and the strength to heal yourself, come back to this episode and it will be here for you. My first little reminder for any of you who are healing your heart right now, or for any of you who are finding it difficult to move on, it is that you were someone before you met this person. You were your own home. You took care of yourself and you were okay. I know how much of a void a loss like this can make in one's life. And I say that very, very carefully because it really hits home. You don't have to apologize for feeling like you couldn't possibly move forward, or like you have nothing to look forward to, or anything along those lines. It's very measurable loss, especially when it comes to someone that you loved, a connection that impacted your life so much. I remember when I was going through my breakup, not really being able to anticipate the future. I was so unbelievably focused on the past, what they added to my life, all of the inside jokes and the laughter and the road trips and the experiences, all of that space that they took up in my life was suddenly emptied out. I felt like I had lost an extension of myself. I felt like there was no possible way that I could ever fill that back up. And then my sister said, "You were full on your own before you met this person. And yes, it's beautiful that you managed to find someone in this world of billions who was able to affect you so much and who was able to show you that you had different levels of depth and care within your heart, who you were able to crash your whole soul into. But at the end of the day, you are your own person and you are your own foundation. Not right now when you feel broken and lost, not just now, but before that person came into your life. And you were doing okay. You were able to take care of yourself. You had hope, you had dreams, you were your own individual human being. And that was so helpful to hear, because while it was very easy for me to just like sit in the midst of my healing and to really, really lament and almost have this sense of nostalgia for what I had experienced in the relationship, being reminded of the fact that I was so happy and capable and hopeful before that relationship even existed was exactly what I needed to remind myself that I could get back to being that person for myself. And I talk about this a lot on this podcast. I understand when I say that, you might think, well, there is no going back. There is no going back to a past version of myself. And I agree. But you can use that past self, that past version, as a reminder that you were once okay without this person in your life. And you have the capacity to do that now. And you're also a stronger human being now. You are different. You will never get back to who you used to be, because who you used to be didn't have to deal with heartbreak and loss and being completely changed at the hands of this world and another human being, which is such a stunning, beautiful reality of opening our hearts up and being vulnerable in this world. Who you were is not who you will be, but who you will be is a strong and capable, independent individual who is going off into the world being reminded that they have the capacity to feel and love and give that love and give that depth to everyone in their life, to their passions, to their hopes, to their dreams, to their family, to their friends, to everything around you. Love is everything around you. And just because this relationship ended does not take away from the fact that you have the capacity to go out into this world and feel that same kind of depth. You are someone you love too. And you are someone who is always capable of taking care of yourself, of being good, of having aspirations and goals and hopes in this world. And just because something ended does not mean that you have to end. So keep going and keep moving forward and understand that you have been there for yourself your whole life. You have taken care of yourself your whole life. You have dug yourself out of the dark on so many occasions, and here you are right now, healing and learning and growing, and it's not easy and it hurts. And I'm sure no one would like to feel this way. I don't think anyone enjoys having these kinds of losses creep into their life. But this is your reminder that you're strong enough to deal with these losses, because you were strong enough to do that on so many occasions prior to this person. And you were always strong, even without them. That was definitely one of the best reminders, one of the best things that my sister could have told me. Like, you know, when someone just shakes you, and not in an ego-driven way, but says, do you know who you are? Do you remember who you used to be outside of all of this? And heal, take your time. You're allowed to feel sad. Your feelings are valid. But remember who you are and who you were and who you want to be, because that potential has always been there, with or without this person. And their inability to choose you or their inability to stay is not a reflection of who you have the capacity to become. So become and keep going. You got yourself, and that will be the longest relationship of your life. The second reminder that really, really helped me when I was healing was that I really had to encourage myself to stop romanticizing the things that hurt. And as someone who feels very deeply, as all of you know, and as someone who wants to just like give every piece of myself to another human being, I am a romantic at heart. I care very deeply. I am empathetic. I have a lot of feelings, if you haven't been able to tell. And it was very, very difficult for me to pull myself out of that almost like romanticism, really looking at love with a very optimistic point of view, which I think is beautiful. And you know, I will never stop encouraging it. But I also think that when you're dealing with a breakup, when you're trying to move on, you have to get real with yourself and very honest with yourself. And that can be hard. It can be hard to admit that someone wasn't as perfect as you might have thought, that a connection wasn't as deep or beautiful or long-lasting as you had seen it when you were like within it. And I think that it is so easy for us to fall in love with potential, and it is so easy for us to romanticize the people in our lives who are kind and good. You know, we want to love, we want to connect, we want to make things work. And I think that can sometimes lead us into turning a blind eye to things that genuinely are not working, things that are incompatible, things that you don't actually want in a relationship. And so when we heal and when we're moving on, I know this was especially difficult for me. It is so easy to hold on to all of that beautiful nostalgia, to say, oh, but they were this, or that one time when they did this. It can be easy to hold on and to look back at all of the beautiful things that they did. That nostalgia is very light. It is very easy to hold and to carry with you and to keep inside of yourself. What you have to do when you're healing is you have to look a little deeper at the stuff that falls to the bottom, the heavy stuff, the things that weren't exactly shining examples of what you wanted in a relationship. And it's easy to turn a blind eye to that. It is easy to forget those things, to put on the blinders and to think that you had this like perfect, beautiful, intense connection when in reality it ended. And being honest with yourself and saying, you know, this person was a great person, but that doesn't mean that they were necessarily great for me. And I loved the idea and the belief in love. I loved the idea that I could give so much of myself to someone, that we could have these memories, that they could impact me the way that they impacted me. But that doesn't mean that someone has to stay in your life, and that doesn't mean that someone is meant to. And so being very honest with yourself. I mean, remember all the beautiful things, don't get me wrong, but also getting really honest with yourself and saying, you know what? I actually didn't really like that about this relationship. I didn't like when they did X or Y or Z, or this character trait or this personality trait didn't mesh well with me, but I always tried my best to make it work. I always tried to fight. I promise you won't have to fight so hard to make the right things connect. And so if you get really clear with yourself, and if you're very honest with your heart, I know this was an extremely difficult thing for me to do. I actually did realize as I was moving on and as I was healing that I couldn't have imagined 50 or 60 or 70 more years with that person if they had never changed. Because that's how you have to love someone, right? And I had all the inside jokes like tucked away in my heart. I had their memories, I had their virtue, I had their goodness that I was just gripping and holding on to so, so tightly. But it's when I just opened my hands and let it go and started being honest with myself that I realized that this person, they weren't my person. The connection ended for a reason. We couldn't beat the odds, and that's okay. Hold on to all of the beautiful and soft and lovely reasons why you fell for this person in the first place. But also remind yourself of why it didn't work out. Stop romanticizing the things that hurt. I promise that the right things stay in your life. They connect. They really do work out. And you don't have to make this person wrong in your mind. You don't have to hate them for leaving. It just is what it is. It didn't work out. This person is not your person, and that is okay. And that is where your healing begins. When that realization, when that really hits you, when you stop kind of seeing the connection through rose-colored glasses and you can start to see it for what it is, that's when you can get really honest about what you want in a relationship and what you actually need and what was working and what wasn't working. So it's less of this living in potential and more of living in reality of what you deserve and understanding that you weren't necessarily fulfilling that within this connection. Another little reminder that really helped me as I was navigating healing, and something that I really needed to hear and be encouraged within, was that closure is not something you're going to get from this person. It is something that you are actually going to give yourself. And that is very difficult to believe in, because we think that the person who broke our heart, or the person who left, or the person who we're mourning right now, the person who we are currently healing from, they are the person who is going to make us feel better. They are the person who is going to give us closure and tie up all the loose ends so perfectly, and heal our hearts with whatever statement or words or expression that they have for you. But I promise you, that is not the case. I remember going back so many times and asking questions and needing to wrap my head around what was going on. There were so many occasions where I was talking with my friends and I was like, oh, I just feel like I need to see this person one more time. I feel like I need to talk to them. They asked me for coffee. That's probably a good idea. You know, we can still be friends. This will make this so much easier. And that wasn't the case. It never healed the wound. The wound was always scratched at in those cases. Me seeking closure, me seeking this healing from this person, was never going to work out, because they couldn't have done my healing for me. And while I understand that closure is important to a lot of people, where we think that if someone just looks us straight in the face and says, no, you're right, yeah, I never loved you, or there's this like big glaring reason that will feel better, that it will make everything feel good and soft and kind again, but that is not the case. It still hurts. It doesn't make it any better, whether you know exactly why something happened, every little tiny minute detail, or whether you don't know why something happened. I promise I've been in both situations, and they are both equally as hard to move on from. And no amount of communication and no amount of closure that these people tried to give me helped me move forward. I helped me move forward. I gave myself permission to start healing. And the reason why it became easier for me as I started moving on was that I kept telling myself, I remember just constantly repeating to myself, sometimes two people don't beat the odds. And sometimes you have a very deep connection with someone and you want it to last forever, and sometimes it just can't happen that way. Sometimes two people cannot make it work. Sometimes things just end, and sometimes they end very beautifully, and every T is crossed and I is dotted, and there is a beautiful period at the end of the sentence, and the chapter is finished and closed perfectly, and the book has no dog ears in it, and it's just pristine. And then some chapters of your life, they end in the middle of the page and the book is falling apart, and there's a million different ways that it can go, and you have no clue where the story is going or what is happening or anything along those lines, and the book just slams shut and you're like like left in the dust of it, but it still ends. And that's the relativity there. It still ended. They still left, or you left. You still decided that there was something more out there for you. The chapter ended. Whether it was beautifully or imperfectly, an ending is still an ending. And I had to remind myself that that was my closure. I can't force someone to want to stay. I can't force someone to love me properly, and I can't force someone to leave me the way that I want to be left. I can't force anything when it comes to love and hearts and the messiness that exists within putting yourself into this world and being a vulnerable person and feeling something deeply for another human being. It's never simple, it's never easy. There's always a little bit of texture to it. And so you can always expect a little bit of that same messiness and grittiness and texture to be included in the endings. It's going to hurt. There's no denying that. There's no getting away from that. There's no sweeping that under the rug. It is going to hurt because you cared. And you are going to want to hold on, and you are going to want to say, no, no, no. If they just tell me this, I'll be good. No. No, I said that on so many occasions, and then I got that closure and I was like, oh, so I still have to do the work, and I still have to like pick up my broken pieces from the floor and like pick out the parts that I didn't want and the memories that I did and like smush them together and like put them back in my chest. I had to do that. They couldn't do that for me. No matter what they gave me, I still had to move forward on my own. And take care of myself and heal myself. And that is when I realized it like hit me so deeply that closure truly, truly is something that you have the capacity and the strength to give yourself. Someone cannot heal your heart for you. I said this before, you are responsible for that. And so whether it was beautiful and whether it was imperfect, you're still gonna be good. You're still gonna be able to give yourself the closure that you so deeply desire from them. And also on that note, when you seek closure in another human being, while it is valid, and I understand that we are meaning-making machines and we want reasons, we need reasons so that they make sense in our head, so that we feel better, so that we have something. While it is easy to want closure from someone else, if you don't get that closure, please promise me that you will not allow that to stop you from moving forward, from picking up the pieces, from doing exactly what I did and moving forward into your potential and into the genuine connections that are waiting for you on the other side of this healing. Because when you do that, when you close yourself off until you receive something from this person, from the person who left, from the person you're healing from, you, in a way, are putting your healing in their hands. When in reality, it should be in your hands, and it always will be in your hands. You cannot be saved by someone. Their words, their closure, anything that they can give you, it will not heal you. You will do that on your own. So try your best not to put your healing in their hands. Try your best not to say, I will move on and I will be okay, but I just need you to do these things for me first. No. You are your own home, and you were okay before you knew them, and you were able to save yourself so many times before. You are in charge of your own healing. It is in your hands, and it is something that you take and you process and you move forward within. You do not need anyone else to give you your own healing. That is on you. That is on you, and you are capable of doing it. Another reminder that I want to share with all of you, and that I think a lot of people who are healing might need to hear right now, is that love is like a fingerprint. And I know that sounds very poetic. I will explain. Love is like a fingerprint. And what you experienced was very unique and very individual and very beautiful and very, very itself. It was a thing that you experienced, a connection that you felt depth within, something that impacted your life and added beauty to it. And that was special. And that was between you and this person who is no longer in your life. And when we experience things like that, we start to define love based on what we have experienced. Love looks a certain way. Love sounds a certain way, love says our name a certain way, love holds us a certain way. And it can be very difficult to break out of that definition. It can be very difficult to understand that there is so much more waiting for you on the other side of your healing. And when I was healing, I know that I was turning down a lot of human beings who could have been very good for me because I did not recognize past love in them. But this is your reminder to stay open, because no two loves are going to be the same. And there are going to be so many human beings in your life who love you very differently than what you might think love looks like right now. And I just want to remind you to keep your heart open, to stay vulnerable, to remind yourself that you are the kind of person who wants to just like slam all that you are into beautiful human beings who come into your life, and to not discount any opportunities like this world is trying to give you when it comes to your heart, because you're comparing or dissecting or wondering if your past is going to influence your future. Don't allow that to happen. No two loves are the same. They are individual fingerprints, and you are going to go off into this world and you are going to find someone and fall into something so unbelievably for you that you will look back on this period of your life and you will say, man, I thought that was it. I really did. I really thought that's what I wanted. But this is so much more for me than I could have ever imagined. And if I had stayed closed off to it, if I hadn't given myself the opportunity to stay open to it, then I never would have felt that. And so while we're healing and while we're moving forward, I want you to take the pieces of the things that you have felt, the things that genuinely grew you and built you and made you feel so loved and seen, and I want you to move forward with those. And look for those, but also understand that there's space for awe when it comes to love. And there's space for so much beauty to find you, beauty that you may not even recognize because it looks so different. It says your name differently, and it holds you differently, and it has different jokes, and you have different conversations and different family dynamics and different friends and et cetera, et cetera. It will be different, but that's the beauty, because it will grow you in a way that you haven't been grown. It will impact your heart in a way that your heart hasn't been impacted. And is that not the most beautiful thing that we could experience in this life? So stay open to it. I had to remind myself so much, don't close yourself off. Keep trying. You have so much to give. You have so much heart. You have so much belief in the beauty and the tenderness of other human beings. Just stay open. Believe in it. And this brings me to my last point, but believe that you're good enough for the people who want to love you in your life. And do not let this loss, do not let the fact that someone left or that something did not work out convince you that you are unworthy of the beauty life has in store for you. You are enough for the people who love you, and you have so much to give the people who are going to love you. You are deserving and you are worthy. And just because you are heartbroken right now does not mean that this is going to be your reality for the rest of your days. And one day, when you least expect it, you are going to meet someone and you are going to crash your whole soul into someone who sees you and who values you and who just fits. The good things connect, the good love connects, and I promise you with, like, I believe in this so much, it's like in my bones how much I believe in it, that you are going to be amazed by the love that is going to find you. you're going to wake up on a Sunday morning beside someone who genuinely makes your cells dance. I will never, ever stop being optimistic about that kind of beauty existing in this world because I have felt it. And I remember looking over and hearing them singing in the shower and being like, this is so ridiculous. Like, it was this fuzzy kind of happiness. And I was like, whoa, I healed. I'm happy. This is so different and yet so beautiful. And it's mine. And I get to feel it. And I get to experience it for this small, however long moment in time. And is that not one of the greatest experiences we have in life? And I know it's going to happen for you. And I know it's hard to believe that. And I know it's easy to doubt. But I promise that it's waiting for you. You are going to be so amazed by what love has in store for you. So heal that heart and do whatever you have to do to make it to tomorrow. And do whatever you have to do to stay open. And if you don't believe in anything that I just described, if you don't believe that your heart holds value right now, if it still feels very broken and heavy, if you don't believe that there is a future where you are going to the farmer's market with someone you love and having Thanksgiving with their family, et cetera, all of the things we dream of and we're sold. If you don't believe that, just listen to this back and let me remind you that it's waiting for you. And then one day it's going to connect and you're going to look back at this and you're going to say, it happened. I really hope that those reminders helped. I hope that they resonated. I hope that they made you feel just heard and seen in what you're navigating right now. You are doing your best, and I'm proud of you because I know how difficult it is. And whenever you need a little encouragement, and whenever you're having a bad day, whenever you feel that like ache of nostalgia come over you, listen to this episode. Do not text them. Do not text them. Don't do it. I believe in you. You can do that. Listen to this episode instead. Have the words encourage you. Have them remind you that you are capable of healing, that your healing is your own responsibility, that it is in your own hands, and that is a beautiful and strong thing, and that you have the capacity to move forward into the kind of love and passion that you deserve. That you can leave the past behind and that you can find something that is so unbelievably for you if you just stay open. So stay open and know that you are loved. Until next time, stay safe out there.